Hey everyone, this is Bazzoka. Welcome to one of my videos. Welcome to Let's Scrub It Out video series where I play games where you can be potentially bad at. And as you can see, I'm using the same loadout I used in the last Let's Scrub It Out. I'm gonna call it the Selfish Pyro loadout because, well, you're selfish. Also, did you notice that? How the Phlogistinator, look at that beautiful stuff. Oh goodness, I can't remember what the guy's name is, but a guy made a particle change, so that way the Phlogistinator's flame isn't like this set kind of thing that looks really freaking confusing. It actually follows the normal particles, and it looks freaking awesome. I will show a... I'll probably put up an annotation or something to make up for that, and yeah, I'll put an annotation linking it to it. As you can see, I jump cut. And yeah, so look at that. It looks so much better than that horrible thing. And then Soda Popper. It's not even strange. Oh well. So anyway, this is more or less kind of a follow-up to my last video, which is called I Like the Phlogistinator. Unfortunately, that was live commentary, and that soldier... That's a spy. But anyway, it's live commentary. I'm not good with live commentary, especially in this kind of setting where it's like, oh, I need to concentrate on this, but then at the same time, I need to do this. So yes, give my true completed thoughts. Yes, so my true completed thoughts are, Phlogistinator. It makes me think very differently how I need to approach certain classes, especially the soldiers and demo men, because I can no longer air blast their projectiles or move the stickies that the demo men lay down. So I'm like, oh, I can't move forward. And especially with this loadout, I don't have an air blast to combat other air blasts. So like, I can't give myself space if a pyro is if an enemy pyro is air blasting me. So as you saw there, unfortunately, that kind of worked out in my favor, because if I get popped into the air, the taunt ends, and I don't have to wait for the rest of the taunt to end. Yeah. So, going around the Phlogistinator, unfortunately, I never get a medic to heal me at all, which is a problem, and I kind of forget that I'm trying to protect the payload cart. And then here I'm like, I gotta live. I can't bother. Look at that. He ended the taunt earlier than it should have been ending. And then I do believe I get hit by a revolver, which means there's a spy somewhere. Especially since, yep, there's a spy there. So he's obviously dead ringer, and then out of nowhere, a lawnmower, and mows me down. yes. So, that was so obviously a spy. Unfortunately, that scout, it seemed like he was AFK or something. Seriously. Sirs! This is super sirs business. And that guy is dead because he didn't burst into flames after I lit the area around a little bit more. And then this guy, he's completely oblivious. Like, yeah, I'm a soldier. I'm on your team, clearly. Clearly not. And there's this guy. And it is my mission to kill all spoys. My mission is complete. Okay, so going on full crits, full inf bar, using up, and going forth. I get really lucky here, and all three of them are looking off to the left for some reason. Now this is the unfortunate part. I'm now up against another pyro on upward, aka I'm gonna get air blasted off, which is another downside to the Phlogistinator. So yes, as unfortunate as that is, I was sticking with it because, well, I was already committing to it. And yes, look at that beautiful Phlogistinator fire. It honestly, I'm so glad that the guy made that this skin, this particle change, because it looks so much more better. Also, watch this. Watch closely. He air blasted me, and then someone just died immediately. I don't know why. It's just, I get air blast, he dies. Instant shattered into nothingness. Also, actually, I don't really have much to say beyond that. So yes, I'm sticking with the Phlogistinator because I'm committing to it. This is a video that I'm making for Let's Scrub It Out. I still need to make a spray for myself that somehow advertises this, I guess. I don't freaking know. Or maybe just, I don't know what I'm getting at. So, still going this, and apparently we need an engineer, but I'm too much of a stubborn person, showing that I can detonator jump. Yes. So, what? Oh yes, that's right. That pause there was, if you didn't notice, a scout got headshotted by a sniper. I was confused as to what happened. But anyway, time skip, because no one wants to wait for like 30 seconds. It's 30 seconds of beautiful time that you could be using to do something else. So, going in here, getting all up close and poisonal. Poisonal? Yes, that's right, poisonal. And dealing with the Delman, and he blows himself up on me, which is... that sounds oddly sexual, so I am sorry for my poor choice of words, and thank you! Spies are always helpful. Pop the crits, because, because I was at low health, and then get this guy, and then this demon man comes out of nowhere. I should have been swaying more around, but that is, hindsight is 20/20, and there's a spy out of spawn, which I hunt down, which I don't think I get him, honestly, because that honestly seems like the perfect amount of time to, for the Dead Ringer to recharge itself, so, I don't know. Now, I was confused at this part. I was like, okay, they already have the middle cap, so, yes, because watch this. There's a demo man, a soldier, and as you saw, there's an engineer out there as well, so I was confused. I'm like, wait a minute, they don't have that cap yet? What's going on here? I was very confused. Also, apparently, I'm taking down Stabby, but I know Stabby is much better than that, honestly. He would have probably headshotted me, or just body-shotted me in general. So, yeah. Unfortunately, I should have popped my meter here. I should have popped my crits, saved my life. Unfortunately, that was not the case. So, now they're getting close to the middle, and I decide to hero mode engage, except not really. Unfortunately, I was not on the cart, and the demo man got on the cart, and there's only so much a Phlogistinator power can do against a bunch of projectiles. And then there's that sentry up in the right corner, like, seriously? And then I get hit again, but then he promptly explodes afterwards, which I am happy about. As you see, I'm gonna go check around for Stabby. Yes, Stabby. I was like, wait a minute, what? Stabby? No way. What? What? Wait, is that really Stabby? That's what was going through my head. But then I saw that he didn't have the pink camera beard. I'm not sure if he would actually use the, like, obvious tells that he's Stabby. And I'm pretty sure that he would change his name for Pubs or something. I don't know. It was kind of fishy. And in the end, it wasn't Stabby. Just so you know, definitely was not the actual Stabby. Because I'm pretty sure he has the itchy and scratchy, avatar. I'm pretty sure, I'm not entirely sure. Here I should have popped crits, but I get crit stickied, so, whatever. As unfortunate as that is. So, yes. And, you know, I didn't really go too deep into detail as to why I'm a good medic buddy. Unfortunately, this heavy is going to interrupt me and kill me. And he only has one kill on that shotgun. I'm guessing I'm the second or the first person he killed? I don't know. Anyway, so, the reason why I'm a good medic buddy is because, as I said in the last video, the back scratcher makes it so I'm healed less from medics and dispensers, but medics still charge their Uber as fast as they normally would. So, if I'm damaged, it takes me longer to be healed, but then I am charging their Uber much faster. And it looked like he was, that soldier, it looked like he was getting ready to pull out the escape plan, but decided to not. I don't know why. But that's just neither here nor there. Gonna go up. If demo knock knock, who's there? Me. And then I probably get destroyed by a black box soldier because I'm a dingus. I should not have stood still. I should have went up to him, started burning him, and then yar. Yes. And then turn the corner. There's Zed apparently. And now what I should have done is gone back for that small health kit, because he one-shotted me. I'm pretty sure that was a body shot, so yes. I'm not fit to attack soldiers, apparently. Because, yeah. Apparently I get a nice shot and kill that demo man, but, you know. Unfortunately, I can't do anything because, once again, I'm a Phlogistinator Pyro. I do not have any form of air blast, so I can't deal with a demo man and a soldier on the cart, really. I need a distraction. I need a distraction to distract the distractions. I'm not sure if that made sense, but whatever. That's not the point. The point is, I can't deal with soldiers and demo men as well. So, and then buff banner, why not? Stickied from somewhere, I honestly have no idea. I was confused. So, let's go up here. Oh hey, mini crit, crit. There could have been no worse situation, and then it happens. We lose. Yeah. No one on the cart, no one stopping the cart, because their team is composed better. They have a better team, unfortunately. For me. But whatever. Me's just scrolling around. Well, I guess that will do it. For this, let's scrub it out. So, yes. Check out that guy's stuff. And unfortunately, no one gives me a high five. No one wants a high five from a pyro with derp eyes. How dare they? That is unacceptable. But yes, check it out. It's awesome, and it also changes the man melter as well, so it gives an obvious cue as to when it's ready to fire. So, I thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys later. Have a great day.